What is this sensation, madam?
Here we found something that is generalized with mind and body.
Okay, here you find something generalized with mind and body. Yes. Very good. Yes. Very good. What is your name?
Dr. Neelima.
Neelima. Very good, Neelima. Okay.
Something that is non-human.
Okay. So, one has to very clearly understand the origin of the sensation method. And what is the centralization? Have you heard this word?
Yes.
Yeah. When you say vital sensation, it means that this particular symptom does not belong to the mind and does not belong to the body. Or this is the symptom that belongs to the mind and belongs to the body. Or it doesn't belong to the mind and the body. Or it is where the difference between the mind and the body disappears. That is the vital sensation. If in a given case, if you find a person reach a point of experience or point of expression, in your case taking, where the difference between the mind and the body merge, that is the central theme of the sensation. And that is where that particular sensation, vital sensation, with its modalities and the experience of it becomes very important, because this vital sensation is what we can call as a general phenomena and not a local phenomena. You start asking the question, is this a local phenomena or is this a general phenomena? Correct? You get what I am saying? Now I will give you a case example. Some exciting moments from my practice. Many years ago, since many years I am into this sensation approach. So this woman comes with severe bronchial asthma, okay? And in her bronchial asthma, when I ask her, tell about your bronchial asthma, then she says that I feel constricted. Then she says I feel restricted. Then she says that as if my breath doesn't belong to me. As if I am not in control of my breath. It feels as if not free. It feels as if it is tight. It feels as if it is choked. It feels suffocated. Now, when the person says this, right? This lady said this much more than what I said. Now I am just making it a little short for you. So when you see this tight, constricted, restricted, not able to move, choked, my breath is not my own, right? What is she talking about? Is she talking only about her asthma? You get my point, what I am saying is, ye andar jana chahiye. What has to go inside? What is the main theme of the sensation approach? the main theme of the sensation approach is that the local is talking the language of the general. That there is nothing local. Everything is one central disturbance which is expressed in different organ systems, different pathological symptoms. It is expressing in the fears, dreams, interest hobbies, relationships, childhood. In all areas of the life, this phenomena is expressing. What appears to be local is never local. This is the main theme of the sensation approach, that once you reach what we call as the vital sensation, if a face is clearly expressing, intensely expressing, spontaneously expressing, some repeatedly expressing some sensation in the local physiopathology, in the experience of the local problem, you will immediately sense that, remember me in your mind, that this is not necessarily local. This is something much more deeper, much more general, much more wider, which is expressing in the local. And that is the journey of taking the patient from the experience in the local to an experience in the general, to an experience beyond the general, out of the time and space dimension. Whatever that experience may be. In, I would say, if you practice this methodology well, if you evolve in this methodology, in 30-40% of the cases, the person can reach what was called as the source. Meaning the very, very substance that the remedy comes from. So, the focus of a sensation approach practitioner is to search for something which looks like the vital sensation, to find that point where the mind and body cross, where the mind symptom and the body symptom becomes one, and the journey is from taking the local to the level of general and beyond general. So the essence of practice of sensation approach is an art, science and practice of case taking, whereby you gently take the patient from local to general and you wait by asking repeatedly, very gently, the same question again and again. It is not a question, but it is a kind of words that the patient is giving you. You are giving those same words back to the patient very gently and saying, tell me more. You said constriction, yes, constriction. Tell me more about this constriction. It feels like restricted, it feels like tight. Yes, constricted, restricted, tight. Little more about this. Describe this a little bit more. You know, my chest, when I get asthma, no, it really feels like a string has been tied. Yes, a string has been tied. A little more about this. Describe this, tell more about this. You are quietly, gently getting the patient to feel those words. These words are very important. in the words can be gestures. A person may say, it feels like this. So just describe what you are showing with your hands. In the sensation approach, there are three, it is an interplay of three levels. I would say four levels, but principally three levels. First level is the level of the sensation, correct? Tight, squeezing, restriction, right? When you keep on asking this tight, restriction, constriction, choking, suffocating, when you will keep on asking, giving these words a little more, what will the person do? What will the person do? The person can tell you that it feels like I am in a jail.
Image.
So you will get an image. When you ask about it, you will get an image, yes or not?
Yes.
Now these images are very important. Why are these images important? Because these images help you to further the case. Image actually becomes an anchor. Different anchors can come up when you are taking a case. Don't confuse this with the anchor that Dr. Shankaran talks in Synergy, okay? These become stepping stones by which you hold and go further. Are you there? You hold and you go further. You hold and you go further. Each image helps you to further the person's journey in the sensation. When you ask about the sensation, the person will go to the image. When you ask about the image, the person will go to the sensation. You ask about the sensation, the person will go into hand gestures. The pattern, hand gestures are the pattern. They are completely non-verbal energy patterns. And certain patterns tend to show up very prominently. And you follow that with the hand gestures. One person can feel, say that, you know this, tell little bit about constriction, restriction. Doctor, it feels like this, you know. Another person can say, doctor, it feels like this. Another person can say, doctor, it feels like this. So, these hand gestures, doctor, it feels like this, you know. Can you see the difference? You already know where the energy in the case is. The vital sensation can be conglomeration of many words. It can be a complex, which is experienced, a complex sensation. What is most important about sensation? One is that the sensation is beyond human. It can be beyond human. It can be human also, but it can be beyond human. It can be anything which is like this. And it is also beyond time and space. And it is general. And it is beyond general, beyond your body also. And the most important is sensation and delusion. You reach a level of experience. Person starts experiencing something. The energy moves inside. At the point when a person goes into a deeper or even deeper experience, he can even go into a mild trance or a severe trance or a moderate trance, doesn't matter. The trance can occur even with open eyes. Because the person is mesmerized into that sensation. Person is resonating with that sensation. Person has connected with that sensation. Then even with the open eyes, when you keep on asking, tell more, the person is likely to go deeper into a strange experience of the sensation. As if all of a sudden the case from asthma will move somewhere else. The whole mindset of a sensational method practitioner is seeing what is general in the local. How the local and the general are tied by a phenomenon. And then seeing that more and more general in different areas of life. What can be described as commonality, so at one point everything will generalize and then you go into the investigation of general. And you know, doctor, my knee joint is very stiff, I'm very anxious about this knee joint because it feels very restricted. Tell about this restricted, I'm very angry. Tell about this angry, I'm boiling with anger. How can I help this knee joint pain? I'm so angry about it. Tell a little bit about more about this anger, this restriction. I feel as if I'm a wild cat in the cage running up and down. You just get me out and I will tear you apart. Can you see the whole aspect? Where will it go? You can immediately see the language. You can see the mannerisms. You can see the where it is going. Chief complaint can be anywhere. A area in a person's life which is most bothersome for him, which is most distressful for him, which is the seat of this ease. What is this ease? Not at ease. Kahan par? Where? Where is the person experiencing maximum this ease? Every homeopath, every healer, every therapist who works with healing modalities, who works with energy patterns. Homeopathy is also an energy medicine. Should look for something where the person is experiencing most severe disease.